Hi, I'm Dave Sweet. I work for Taco and I'm the product manager of the zone controls. And I wanted to take this opportunity to show you some of the new features that we're displaying here at AHR 2024. We're coming out with a new series of switching relays and zone valve controls. And really, in a nutshell, we're taking the EXP functionality and putting it into the base unit. So now there's no longer an expandable version. You would just buy the new version that happens to be a Dash 5 series on there, and you would get all that functionality that's built into the expandable in the base unit. So we've done some other things to help customize that. I'll show you those. We made the cover come off much easier. It just hinges, comes right off. We give you a space to label what your zones are here. Instead of taking a Sharpie and writing on the cover, I can use my label maker or put it directly on here. We give you more diagnostic lights, main boiler end switch, priority boiler end switch, auxiliary outputs. All that's built into here. Another thing we've done too, on the zone valve control specifically, we bring in line voltage directly to the board. Before, we used to have to bring it into the pigtails on the transformer and put a jumper in. Now it's line voltage output to each one of the zones. Circulators, much easier to wire up and install. We've actually shrunk the board down and made more space inside of this control to wire it up. There's knockouts top, bottom, and back now. So again, much easier to mount it. If you like that free floating look, mount it on the wall, all the wires go through the back, clean installation. For features, again, not only do we give you all the expandable features, so right out of the box you get what you're accustomed to and using, we've also added a sensor connection on here. If you hook up a sensor on here and put that on the hot water pipe, I can do domestic recirculation. It does smart plus logic automatically. It senses that, whether it's a zone valve control or the switching relay, you have that same functionality to be able to do that. So we made it clean, easy to wire, transformer is serviceable now, easy to replace. You can add a second one if you want to on there. But one of the biggest changes is in the communications. Right now, when you do that expansion or connect multiple panels together, we use more of a digital on-off communication, either high or low on a few terminals. Now we use Modbus, full two-way communication. So if I have multiple panels tied together, I'm carrying that information from each one back and forth so we know what's going on. And, oh, by the way, it can talk to other equipment in the mechanical room. There's a boiler manufacturer here that connects directly to our Modbus terminals, and they see what zones call and they can pick or do different things, either output or temperature, based on what's happening with this control. Same thing, we've served them information, they can turn on inputs and outputs too. So it's true communication back and forth. So with that Modbus, gives us a lot more flexibility in the field and doing there. Just put this down. But the biggest change is, and again, all this is optional, it has Bluetooth and a mobile app if you want to. Kind of backpedaling a little bit. Out of the box, it's gonna work for that 90% of all jobs that people need to. Thermostat calls, open a valve or turn on a pump and enable the boiler. But there are times when I may want to do something different. Perfect example is, maybe zone 3 is a micro zone, very small zone. When it calls, the boiler runs 20 seconds, 30 seconds and shuts off. It's annoying, it's not good for the equipment, it's not good for it. So I can download our Taco Control mobile app and go into here and say main boiler end switch, uncheck zone 3. So it will not enable that output. Now when there's a call, zone 3 by itself, more than likely the heat in the system is enough to satisfy that zone, or another zone calling could turn on in a minute or two and satisfy that, but we never short cycle it. The other thing is, through the mobile app, I can change the functionality of both boiler end switches and three different aux outputs on here. So imagine that micro zone, I could either not fire it or I could turn on another zone at the same time to give more load every time that calls. So we can still call independently, but when that one does, it may turn on the radiant floor in the basement or something, whatever. heat I want to go to, but it just gives me that ability to suck up that heat. But I have all that in here. So without going crazy, the app gives you so much information. I can name the zones. So if the installer looks at here, he's get the zones names. I can name the panel and where it is. This one's in the crawl space. This one's in the mechanical room. Here's what it's doing. I can, like I say, custom configure the output on there. I can do association of certain things to here. It's amazing, the list goes on and on. I can check for updates on software. As we come out with new features, you may want to enable those functionality. I go up to it, check for firmware update, hit update, boom, and away we go. Gives you all that ability. So as a base unit, you always get that. Whether it's a 2-zone, 3-zone, 4-zone, 6-zone for pumps or valves, you always get Bluetooth, you always get that sensor input. And then there's an option you can buy, I'm showing it here on this one, is a little daughter card that plugs in, and it gives me indoor reset and outdoor reset. So now I can not only control my inputs and outputs, I can actually control temperature. So with indoor reset, it's basically watching what the thermostats are doing. They short cycle, it looks like I probably have too high a water temperature. If they're on too long, I'm probably too low, and I'll try to find that happy ground. But the advantage to indoor, it's kind of giving you that load information, the building load. And then we all know the true outdoor reset is kind of like the holy grail. That's, we know that works. We put a sensor out there, blah, 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 and away we go. So you get the choice of indoor reset, outdoor reset. You can turn an on-off boiler on through the end switch, or if I have a ModCon boiler, I have the ability to set up 0 to 10 volts or 4 to 20 milliamp output. So now I can drive that modulating condensing. So again, on off, modulating, whatever. But that's not where the story ends, because I don't have to just go to a boiler. I can go to a radiant system out of here. I could just enable the boiler out of the end switch and go to an actuator that got 0 to 10 volt and control the temperature to a radiant floor. Or I can go to a variable speed pump like below 34E or 26E. And drive that to do injection. So there's a lot of opportunity with this card that plugs in and the ability to connect it. So these are just some high level things that we can do with there, but the mobile app really can unlock those features, as we say. But remember, out of the box, it works just like a zone panel with that you expect it to. If that installer wants to do some advanced features, download the mobile app. It's called Taco Control. And you can configure your outputs or inputs or set up this reset capability all within that mobile app. The other thing it could do is domestic recirc, as we said, but in the mobile app, I can set the timing. How long is that pump on? How long is it off? Some other things. So there's many more in a short period of time. That's all I have to really tell you. So thank you for your time, and I appreciate it. Look for more information when these get released later in the year. Thanks.